This video covers a couple of January sessions at the boards at Dungeness. In my experience, this always used to be the best time for dab fishing here. I've arrived as the tide is already receding, so I have set up close to the water's edge. I should really have got here earlier and fished over high tide, which always used to be the time I used to catch them. So, based on my last session, which was fished closer to the power station, I'm probably going to have to wait nearer to low tide in order to get a few bites. My rod tips are bouncing about a bit as the waves are hitting the line. Perhaps I should have held the rods higher at this stage, but I am fishing for flatfish, so I'm keeping them relatively low. Something's had a go at the bait on the bottom hook, so that needs to be replaced. I'm fishing sticky black lug tipped with sprat. Time for the obligatory look at my gear and rigs. No surprises here. Normal setup and boom rigs as choice for dabs. To start off with, the bait's the same on both rigs. The only difference is that the long wired boom rig has got beads incorporated in the hook lengths. Wired leads to begin with, but I swap over to continental ones closer to low water. Having recast both rigs, I now cover the location. The map shows some of Dungeness' venues, and the boards, or the boardwalk as some people call them, are close to the point on the west side. To fish for dabs, I like to go anywhere between the power station and just before the point. The boards are quite close to the new lighthouse. To get to the boards, you come off the estate road and park close to the Britannia pub. They make life a lot easier crossing the shingle, and it doesn't really matter which side of them that you fish. For this video, both sessions were filmed from the same spot on the power station side. thought I had a bite, but I think that's only wishful thinking at this stage. If there was something there, it's come up on the way in. The tidal pool's picked up now, and there's a nice bend in the rod tips. I then get my first proper bite. Unfortunately, it looks like I've missed it. Or, once again, if there was something there, it's come off. But at least I know that was a definite bite now. Sprat's gone, so maybe the fish was just interested in that. I'll get another bite as I started to move my gear down the beach. This time it feels like I've got something on. Well, it took a while to catch, but at least the first fish is a dab. The odd cast has dropped short, but so far hasn't made much difference as to where I'm casting. It's been very slow up to this point. It's getting closer to low tide and the sun has started to go down. That's better. At last it looks like they're coming on to feed. Double shot this time, so it's definitely improving. Sunset's arrived, and unfortunately, so have whiting. I would have welcomed a triple shot at the start of the session when nothing else was happening, but not now. double shot of whiting on the other rod signals the time to pack up. So not the best of sessions, with only 10 fish caught, 6 whiting and 4 dabs. I was back again towards the end of the month, this time to fish a tide over low water and all the way up. I decided to fish the same spot, and for those who haven't seen the venue, a few of the boards themselves. To my left is the new lighthouse, which is close to the point. It's a lot easier walking on the boards than trudging across that shingle. Behind me you can see the old lighthouse, the power station and the lookout. Pretty much the same approach as before, but because it's low water, I'm starting with breakaway continental leads. Quick look at the bait, there's a mole sticker back lug on the right hand side and the newer stuff on the left. This time I've opted for shorter wire booms and the Sheppy rig. In contrast to the previous session, I'm getting indication straight away. And although it's not very big, that's a pretty good start. Tide's coming in now, I'll get my second part. With continental leads, dragging the rigs is easier. Tab number two is not much bigger than the first. This time it's on the top hook of a Sheppey rig. Time to start moving up the beach, and I'm starting to think that maybe I should have got here a lot earlier and fished a whole of the low water. No time to settle down before I get another bite. Double shot this time with a decent sized fish on a middle boom. The tide's coming in quite quickly now. I'll get my second double shot, but it's back to the smaller fish. time for the second move up the beach. Bites slow up and the temperature starts to drop. This will be my third and probably final move up the beach if things don't pick up. After a long quiet spell, I get a bite out of a blue. This is dab number 7. At this point, I did think about packing up, but having just caught, there's always a chance of catching something else. So there was to be one more move up the beach. I should really have packed up, since no more bites were forthcoming. So, I ended up with those 7 dabs. Didn't seem to make any difference whether it was a fresh lug or the sticky black lug which they preferred. However, I am convinced that tipping sprat does help. As to the rigs, that didn't seem to make any difference either, for all of them had short hook lengths and small hooks. One surprise though, is that there were no whiting present.